This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Iboricum, Iberchum, or Ibrkame, was a fort and city in the Roman province of Britannia in its prime. It was the largest town in northern Britain and a provincial capital. The site remained occupied after the decline of the Roman Empire and ultimately evolved into the present-day city York, occupying the same site in North Yorkshire, England. Two Roman emperors died in Iboricum, Septimius Severus in 211. 531 Death of Septimius Severus. 6 Economy. 61 Roads. 62 Rivers. 7 Late Roman York. 8 Rediscovery of Roman York. 9 Archaeological Remains. 91 Visible Remains. 10 In Popular Culture. 11 See also. 12 Bibliography. 13 References. 14 External links. Etymology. The first known recorded mention of Iboricum by name is dated c. 95-104. The etymology of Iboricum is uncertain, as the language of the indigenous population of the area was never recorded. However, the generally accepted view of British history is that the inhabitants of Britain at this time spoke a Celtic language related to modern Welsh. This language has been reconstructed from Latin place names and modern Celtic languages, and has been called by scholars Common Brythonic. The name Iboricum is thought to have derived from the Common Brythonic Ibrikon, which probably means place of the yew trees. The word for yew was probably something like Ibura in Celtic, cf. Old Irish Ibar, yew tree, Irish, yew, older Iobar, Scottish Gaelic, Uber, Welsh, efwr, alder buckthorn, Breton, ever, alder buckthorn, combined with the suffix acon, place, cf. Welsh og, meaning place of the yew trees, cf. Efrog in Welsh, ebrach, ubrach in Irish Gaelic, and ebrach, iobrach in Scottish Gaelic, by which names the city is known in those languages. The name is then thought to have been Latinized by replacing acon with acum, according to a common use noted in Gaul and Lusitania. The different Avery, Ivry, Ivry, Ivory in France would all come from Iboricum, Iboriacum. For example, Ivry le Bataire, Ebriaco in 1023-1033, Ivry le Temple Evriacum in 1199, Avery Esun, Ebriaco in 1158, etc. In Lusitania, the city of Ibora, later Ibora Cerealis, and the town of Iborobritium, modern-day Abydos, would also come from the same Iboricum, Ibor Iboriacum root, despite the different form of Latinization used in the Abydos, as the ending itself Britium was either of Celtic or unknown origin. Origins. The Roman conquest of Britain began in 43. Legionary fortress. From its foundation, the Roman fort of Iboricum was aligned on a northeast-southeast bearing on the north bank of the River Ouse. It measured 1,600 pays monetalis, 4,736 meters by 1,360 pays monetalis, 40,256 meters, and covered an area of 50 acres, 200,000. Magnesian limestone from the quarries nearby. The Roman settlement of Calcarea. Tadcaster marble bust of Constantine the Great from Stonegate, York. Emperors. There is evidence that the Emperor Hadrian visited in 122 on his way north to plan his great walled frontier. He certainly brought with him the 6th Legion to replace the existing garrison. Emperor Septimius Severus visited Iboricum in 208 and made it his base for campaigning in Scotland. The fortress wall was probably reconstructed during his stay, and at the east angle it is possible to see this work standing almost to full height. The imperial court was based in York until at least AD 211, in which year Severus died and was succeeded by his sons, Caracalla and Geta, in the later 3rd. Constantine's reign was a time of prosperity, and a number of extensive stone town houses of the period have been excavated. Government for the Romans. Iboricum was the major military base in the north of Britain, and, following the 3rd Iboricum, a 1st-century warehouse fire from Coney Street, on the north bank of the Ouse and outside the fortress, showed that spelt wheat was the most common cereal grain used at that time, followed by barley. Cattle, sheep, goat and pig are the major sources of meat. Hunting scenes, as shown through Romano-British hunt cups, suggest that hunting is a popular pastime, and diet would be supplemented through the hunting of hare, deer and boar. A variety of food preparation vessels, mortaria, have been excavated from the city, and large millstones used in the processing of cereals have been found in rural sites outside the Colonia at Heslington and Stamford Bridge. In terms of the ceremonial use of food, dining scenes are used on tombstones to represent an aspirational image of the deceased in the afterlife, reclining on a couch and being served food and wine. The tombstones of Julia Velva, Mantinea Mercia, and Aelia Aeliana each depict a dining scene. Additionally, several inhumation burials from Trenholm Drive contained hen's eggs placed in ceramic urns as grave goods for the deceased. Mithraic Tauroctony scene. seen from Micklegate, evidence of the cult of Mithras in Eboricum religion. A range of evidence of Roman religious beliefs among the people of Eboricum have been found, including altars to Mars, Hercules, Jupiter and Fortune. In terms of number of references, the most popular deities were the spiritual representation genius of Eboricum and the mother goddess. There is also evidence of local and regional deities. Evidence showing the worship of Eastern deities has also been found during excavations in York. For example, evidence of the Mithras cult, which was popular among the military, has been found, including a sculpture showing Mithras slaying a bull and a dedication to Arimanius, the god of evil in the Mithraic tradition. The Mithraic relief located in Micklegate suggests the location of a temple to Mithras right in the heart of the Colonia. Another example is the dedication of a temple to Serapis, a Hellenistic Egyptian god, by the commander of the 6th Legion, Claudius Hieronymianus. Other known deities from the city include Tethys, Veteres, Venus, Sylvanus, Teutates, Schnubus, and the imperial Numen. There was also a Christian community in Eboricum, although it is unknown when this was first formed, and in archaeological terms, there is virtually no record of it. The first evidence of this community is a document noting the attendance of Bishop Eborius of Eboricum at the Council of Arles in 314. The episcopal see at Eboricum was called Eboricensis in Latin, and bishops from the see also attended the First Council of Nicaea in 325, the Council of Sardica, and the Council of Ariminum. Sarcophagus of Julia Fortunata, found in 1887, now in the Yorkshire Museum. Death and burial. The cemeteries of Roman York follow the major Roman roads out of the settlement. Excavations in the castle yard next to Clifford's Tower, beneath the railway station, at Trentholm Drive and the Mount have located significant evidence for human remains using both inhumation and cremation burial rites. The cemetery beneath the railway station was subject to excavations in advance of railway works of 1839-41, 1845, and 1870-7. Several sarcophagi were unearthed during this phase of excavations, including those of Flavius Bellator and Julia Fortunata. Inhumation burial in sarcophagi can often include the body being encased in gypsum and then in a lead coffin. Variations on this combination exist. The gypsum casts, when found undisturbed, frequently retain a cast impression of the deceased in a textile shroud. Surviving examples of both adults and children show a selection of textiles used to wrap the body before interment, but usually plain woven cloth. The high number of sarcophagi from Eboricum has provided a large number of these casts, in some cases with cloth surviving adhered to the gypsum. Two gypsum burials at York have shown evidence for frankincense and another clear markers of Pistacia spp. Mastic resin used as part of the funerary rite. These resins had been traded to Eboricum from the Mediterranean and Eastern Africa, or Southern Arabia, the latter known as the Frankincense Kingdom in antiquity. This is the northernmost confirmed use of aromatic resins in mortuary contexts during the Roman period. An excavation in advance of building work underneath the Yorkshire Museum in 2009 located a male skeleton with significant pathology to suggest that he may have died as a gladiator in Eboricum. Death of Septimius Severus. The Emperor Septimius Severus was cremated in Eboricum following his death in AD 211. The Roman biographer Cassius Dio records the event and described a scene in which the emperor utters the final words to his two sons on his death bed: agree with each other, make the soldiers rich, and ignore everyone else. Severus was cremated somewhere outside the fortress wall, and again, Cassius Dio paints a picture. His body, arrayed in military garb, was placed upon a pyre, and as a mark of honor, the soldiers and his sons ran about it, and as for the soldiers' gifts, those who had things at hand to offer them put them upon it, and his sons applied the fire. A hill to the west of the city, named Severus Hill, is associated by some antiquarians as the site where this cremation took place, but no modern archaeological investigation has so far corroborated this claim. Economy. The military presence at Eboricum was the driving force behind early developments in its economy. In these early stages, Eboricum operated as a command economy, with workshops growing up outside the fortress to supply the needs of the 5,000 troops garrisoned. Their production included military pottery until the mid-3rd. In the Aldwark Pisum Green area, glassworking at Coppergate, metalworks and leatherworks producing military equipment in Tanner Row. In the Roman period, Eboricum was the major manufacturing center for Whitby jet, known as Gagates in Latin. It was used from the early 3rd. formally planned, although its path is conjectured to run beneath the York Museum Gardens rivers. The River Ouse and River Foss provided important access points for the importation of heavy goods. The existence of two possible wharves on the east bank of the River Foss support this idea. A large deposit of grain, in a timber structure beneath modern-day Coney Street, on the northeast bank of the River Ouse suggests the existence of storehouses for moving goods via the river. Late Roman York. The decline of Roman Britain in early 5th century AD led to significant social and economic changes all over Britain. Whilst the latest datable inscription referencing Eboricum dates from AD 237, the continuation of the settlement after this time, a certain building work in the city continued in the 4th century under Constantine and later Count Theodosius. The locally produced Crambeck ware pottery arrives in Eboricum in the 4th century, the most famous form being intricately decorated buff yellow parchment ware painted with bright shades of red. The effect of Constantine's religious policy allowed the greater development of Christianity in Roman Britain. A bishop of York named Eborius is attested here, and several artifacts decorated with Chi Rho symbols are known additionally. A small bone plaque from an inhumation grave bore the phrase Soror Avenue Vivas in Deo, Hail Sister May You Live in God. Changes in the layout of both the fort and Colonia occurred in the late 4th century AD, suggested as representing a social change in the domestic lives of the military garrison here, whereby they might have lived in smaller family groups with wives, children or other civilians. Rediscovery of Roman York. The rediscovery and modern understanding of Eboricum began in the 17th. Brought many new discoveries to the attention of the public through published articles in his newspaper The Herald and The Current, and published a series of guides with references to casual finds. The first large-scale excavations were undertaken by S. Miller from Glasgow University in the 1920s with a focus on the defences. Archaeological remains. Substantial physical remains have been excavated in York in the last 2 centuries, including the city walls, the legionary bath house and headquarters building, civilian houses, workshops, storehouses, houses and cemeteries. Visible remains of the Roman Basilica building, at the north side of the Principia, are visible in the undercroft of York Minster. A column found during excavations and a modern statue of Constantine the Great are visible outside the multangular tower of York City walls as a multi-period structure based on the southwest corner tower of the Roman legionary fortress. It is within the York Museum Gardens. The Roman Bath Pub and Museum St. Sampson's Square displays remains of the legionary bath house. A large number of Roman finds are now housed in the Yorkshire Museum. The York Museum Gardens have Roman sarcophagi on open display. In popular culture, the Roman city is mentioned in Robert Heinlein's novel Have Space Suit, Will Travel. It also features in King Arthur II. The role-playing wargame is the base of a fictional group of Roman families who stayed on after the evacuation by Rome of Britannia. The Roman city is the location for Semper Fidelis, a detective novel by Ruth Downey, part of Hermeticus series. See also History of York. Roman Britain. Seal of New York City, which is inscribed Sigillum Civitatis Novi Eboraci. Bibliography. Allison Jones, 1996. Roman Jet in the Yorkshire Museum. York, Yorkshire Museum. Drake, F. 1736. Eboricum or the History and Antiquities of the City of York. Ottaway, P. 2004. Roman York. Tempus, Stroud RCHME, 1962. Eboricum, Roman York. Royal Commission on Historical Monuments. England. Well-beloved, C. 1852. First edition. A descriptive account of the antiquities in the grounds and in the Museum of the Yorkshire Philosophical Society. References. Carrot, Eboricum, Collins Dictionary ND, retrieved 26 September 2014. Carrot, Delamere 159. Carrot, Evra, Ficonlinet, retrieved 6 May 2009. pp. 253-274. Carat RCHME, 1962, Eboricum, Roman York. Royal Commission on Historical Monuments. England. P. 106. Carat RCHME, 1962, Eboricum, Roman York. Royal Commission on Historical Monuments. England. P. 118. A. Carat Hall. English Heritage, Book of York. pp. Carat Ancient See of York. New Advent. 2007. Retrieved 25 October 2007. Roman Gladiator, retrieved 6 November 2013. Carat York Museums Trust. 2006, Ivory Bangle Lady, retrieved 13 December 2013. VE major towns of Roman Britain. Placenames in brackets are either present-day names or counties where the towns formerly existed. Capitals: Britannia Superior, Londinium, London; Britannia Inferior, Eboricum; York, Camulodunum; Colchester, surviving Caesaromagus; Chelmsford, Carinium; Dobinorum, Cirencester; Deva, Victrix; Chester, Duravernum; Canticorum, Canterbury; Durnoveria, Dorchester; Glevum, Gloucester; Isca Augusta, Caerleon; Isca Dumnonurum, Exeter; Isarium, Brigantum; Aldborough, Lactodurum; Toaster, Lindum; Colonia, Lincoln; Lugavallium, Carlisle; Moradunum, Carmarthen; Noviomagus, Reginorum; Chichester, Petuaria; Brough, Rattay; Coriatovorum; Leicester, Venta; Belgarum, Winchester; Venta; Silorum; Caerwent; Verulamium; St. Albans; Viroconium; Cornavurum; Roxeter; Extinct; Alchester; Wendelbury; Banaventa; Northamptonshire; Caliva; Atrebatum; Hampshire; Cunicia; Wiltshire; Venta; Isnorum; Norfolk. List of Roman place names in Britain. VE Roman visitor sites in the UK: Villas Bignor, Brading, Chedworth, Crofton, Dover; Painted House, Fishbourne; Great Whitcomb, Littlecote, Lullingstone; Newport, Piddington; Rockbourne, Sparshalt; Roxeter, Forts; Ribchester, Richborough; Segedunum; Venta; Isnorum; Vindolanda towns; Aldborough. Roman site: Colchester, Corbridge, Silchester; Venta; Isnorum; St. Albans; Roxeter. Museums: Canterbury Roman Museum, Carvoran Roman Army Museum, Colchester Castle Museum, Carinium Museum, Jewry Wall Museum, Ribchester; Senhouse Roman Museum, Trimontium Trust, Melrose; Verulamium Museum. Other sites: Bath Roman Baths, Caerleon Roman Baths, Jewry Wall, Leicester; Welland Roman Baths, York Roman Baths.